Today I want to talk about treatment in another group that's often vulnerable, which is transgender women. What have we learned about transgender women so far at this conference?
Well, it's not just what we've learned here, but what we know in general. And transgendered women are a tremendously stigmatized and at-risk population. The statistic that we heard last night at the opening session is that in Europe here, approximately 50% of all transgendered women are already HIV positive. And the person who gave the opening, at the presentation, the opening presentation told their story, and it was really compelling. They had been kicked out of their family, they'd moved to Italy, and in order to survive, in many ways were forced into sex work, became HIV positive, moved to France, where they could get treatment, and over time felt, this person had an unbelievably resilient individual, built up an NGO that deals with the needs of the transgender women here in France. So it was a story of survival, but ultimately at the clinical level, the problem is we have this issue of the interactions, the drug-drug interactions that occur, not just particularly for transgendered individuals, with their hormone therapy, with the other medications they take, plus their antiretrovirals, and a lot is not known about this. So we have a stigmatized group that doesn't necessarily, they have to prioritize. Do I take my hormone therapy or do I take my antiretrovirals? And how do I then deal with my physician to discuss this? And because of the nature of the relationship between a stigmatized individual and the healthcare system, they may not wish to disclose. And so it really is a problem. And so we need a new dialogue, a new set of approaches, and new information to help this population receive optimal treatment with their hormone therapy as well as their antiretrovirals.